Welcome to Systems of Linear Inequalities. The goal of this video is to graph the solution to a system of linear inequalities. And this video does assume that you've watched linear inequalities in two variables. The solution to a system of linear inequalities consists of the region for which any point xy satisfy the linear inequalities of the system at the same time. So the steps to graphing the solution to a system of linear inequalities are as follows. Step 1, we will graph and shade the solution to the first linear inequality. Step 2, we'll graph and shade the solution to the second linear inequality on the same coordinate plane. And the region that is double shaded is the solution to the system. I should mention, if the number of inequalities n in the system is more than 2, then we'll look for the region shaded n times. So if it has 3 inequalities, you're looking for the region shaded 3 times, and so on. And also, some systems may not have a solution. So let's graph the solution to this system. X is greater than negative 4, so we'll graph the line x equals negative 4, but it will be dashed because of the inequality symbol. That would look like this. We could pick a test point. If we picked the point 0, 0 and subbed in 0 for x, we'd have 0 is greater than negative 4, which is true. So we will shade the right side of this plane. So this is the solution to the first linear inequality. Now we need to graph the solution to the second linear inequality and then determine the double shaded region. So here we have y is less than or equal to 2. So we need to graph the line y equals 2, and it will be solid because the line will be part of this solution. Remember, y equals 2 is a horizontal line through y equals 2. And because this one is solved for y, and it says y is less than or equal to 2, we would shade below the blue line. So we would shade this region. So the solution to the system would be the region that is shaded by both linear inequalities. And you can see that this is the region here that is shaded both in red and in blue. Now, to make this more clear, what we can do is clearly identify the double shaded region. And in fact, when you're doing your homework on the computer will only want you to shade the double shaded region. Let's try another. Let's first graph y is less than negative x plus 2. So we'll graph the line y equals, this is the same as negative 1x or negative 1 over 1x plus 2, but it will be dashed. So we plot our y-intercept. So with a slope of negative 1, we will go down 1 and right 1 several times. And again, remember our line is dashed. Because this is solved for y, we can take that shortcut. It says y is less than negative x plus 2. Less than means we'll shade below. So I would shade this region here. Next, we'll graph and shade the second inequality. So for this inequality, we're going to graph the line y equals 3x minus 4. So our slope will be 3 over 1. So we have a y-intercept of negative 4. Slope of 3 over 1, so up 3, right 1. And again, it's a solid line. And it reads y is greater than or equal to, so that would be above the line. Now again, we could pick a test point, but I am taking the shortcut because they are solved for y. So the double shaded region would be our solution. You can see it's the region on the left. Let's go ahead and make it more clear. The region we're talking about is bordered by this dashed line and this solid line. and everything in this region. So if we picked a point in this region, substituting the x and y values, both inequalities would be true with the same values. Let's go ahead and try one more. Here we have two linear inequalities where both lines would be solid. So the first line would be x minus 2y equals 4. Since it's in standard form, I will go ahead and find the x and y intercepts. So the y-intercept, when x is 0, we'd have negative 2y equals 4. Dividing by negative 2, we'd have y equals negative 2. Next, when y is 0, we would have x equals 4. Let's go ahead and plot these two points and sketch our solid line. 0, negative 2, 4, 0. Would look something like this. Now, one thing you can do to eliminate some of the confusion with the shading, when we pick our test point, let's say we test 0, 0, we can see in this inequality that that would be 0 and that would be 0. So the question becomes, is 0 less than or equal to 4, which is true. So we would shade the same side as the test point. So we would shade in this direction. So instead of shading, we can just draw the arrows to see where we will shade. Let's go ahead and try this with the second inequality. So we're going to graph the line x minus 2y equals negative 4. Again, we'll find the intercepts. So when x is 0, we would have negative 2y equals negative 4. Divide both sides by negative 2, we have a y value of 2. Next, when y is 0, we'd have x equals negative 4. Plot these two points. 0, 2, negative 4, 0. Next, we'll use 0, 0 again to test which half to shade. So when x is 0 and y is 0, the left side is still 0. 0 greater than or equal to negative 4. Again, this is true, so this time we'll shade the same side as the test point. So it would shade down. And you can probably see now that the double shaded region would be the region between these two lines. So now we can make that region very clear by shading just the double shaded region. If you find the arrows a little bit easier to use, I would encourage you to do so. But this region is the solution to the system of linear inequalities. I hope you found this video helpful.